Staffordshire University is a renowned university for digital excellence, one of the first universities to adopt computer studies a long time ago, and since then has become the number one place to study for games, anything to do with games, games art, games design. We have over 1,000 games design students, more than any other university in the UK. We look at what's new, what's fresh, what's coming up, and we look at where the jobs are. Essentially, as a university, it's really important that we are preparing our graduates for not just careers for now, but for careers of the future.
We have a broadcast newsroom, we also have a TV studio, radio studios, and of course the new esports hub, and we have now been part of the esports arena development in London.
We began work about 3 years ago now, looking at esports and looking at the evolution of the industry, looking at where it had come from, what kinds of jobs are available there. So it's become one of the most popular degrees that we do, alongside, as I said, computer games design. The esports degree is a combination of curriculum from the business school, but also from the computer games area as well. So the students that come in and do esports, they're not learning how to play esports games. That's a common myth which the media keeps throwing around, but that is definitely not what they do.
We give the students an all-round overview of the technical equipment and facilities used within the broadcast industry.
We deliver a combination every year of business skills, so they learn about human resources, marketing, finance. They learn a lot about event management and all of the different skills that they need to make an event work in exactly the same way that you would learn on any other business degree.
We got together and we looked into different technologies that we could use within the esports hub, and the NDI protocol from NewTek was certainly something that we wanted to look further into, and that's what we did. We could have gone for the old traditional way of SDI, but we knew that that is not the way forward, and we knew that there had to be a different way, and that's why we chose to go with NDI. NDI has made our workflows a lot more straightforward. I myself am not from a traditional broadcast background. There was very little setup, and once we were going, that was it. No long runs of cables. So in terms of cameras and control surfaces, the different pieces of kit that we use now are no longer requiring the old SDI cabling. We can run from just a couple of Ethernet cables. Using existing network infrastructures within the university, we were able to hit the ground running with NDI. In our new facility in London, we centre around the NewTek VMC1 unit and the two-strap control surface. The input devices that are connected to that, we've got three Panasonic studio cameras, the NDI CX350 cameras. We also use a Panasonic PTZ camera to give an overview of the 12 gamers. We've also got 12 machines altogether which the gamers can play with, and that sends the display signal from those PCs back to our VMC1. So we've got a various amount of NDI sources that are coming into our VMC1. We're using the Spark converters for several things. First, to pull in feeds from games consoles, so we can connect games consoles into the Sparks, straight into the NDI network. The other reason that we're using the Sparks is because the Panasonic cameras that we're using on site, the CX350s, their NDI output is only 1080, whereas if we use a Spark, it gives us a 4K feed. So during an actual production, we might have up to four presenters at the presenter desk. Each of those presenters has a kind of mini PC situated at their specific workstation. Again, these are part of our NDI network, and we are able to allow those presenters to choose any of the NDI sources. They can pick and choose whether it's preview, program output, any individual source that's coming in. So we've got full flexibility. We stream directly from the VMC1. The amount of streaming capabilities that it has far exceeds our requirements. We can stream to several places at once if we need to. Facebook, Twitch, YouTube, you name it, the VMC1 can handle it. The thing that pulls all of the streams together is the Netgear switch. It pulls in all of the NDI sources, including the cameras, the PCs, the VMC1. Everything connects to this central hub, and then everything can speak to one another straight away. We use our own internal network so that all of our NDI traffic does not even have to touch the traditional university traffic. There's a lot that goes into what we do, and new tech and NDI just fits hand in glove with what we teach.